How does one conquer the oceans? How does one become the king of the sea? Well, brace yourself, hang on tight, because Crystalis Dota will show you how. In this episode, we get a little taste of the sea kings of Dota. This is Mineski. Mineski is a prime example of a student in your classroom that you pick on, you kick, you bully, and you think that person will never strive to become anything. That person will be a failure in life, you know, that you look at that person that way. But boy, was the Dota world wrong. Mineski pulled off an upset in a grand final game in the Chinese International, the DAC. To win this major tournament, it's a big accomplishment. It's not a little one. You see, a Philippine team has never achieved this big of a goal. They never achieved it. So that little kid that everyone was picking on, well, now has showed the big boys that, hey, I am something. I have pushed myself to be something. This is a story of Mineski, the team that never gave up, that always tried their hardest, that plays with passion and continues to put forth their impacts to Dota. To this day, we have beautiful Dota because of teams like this in the professional scene. So Mineski is a professional gaming organization established in the Philippines. The team is known to be one of the strongest in Southeast Asian electronic sports. However, they have never really won any great tournaments. If you look at the Liquipedia tournament achievements, you will see that the biggest achievement was in 2017 when they won the PGL Open Bucharest against LGD. The funny part is, a year later, on April the 7th, 2018, they have just won a major tournament. Their biggest and most brightest achievement by far.
Age Mineski.
In fact, they won the Dota 2 Asia Championships of 2018 against, yes, I bet it's deja vu for them, but against LGD Game yet again. Perhaps they just know how to defeat this team. But if you look at the series, it really was a nail biter. It was really, really close. Mineski won 3-2. Apparently, their Dota style was so unorthodox. It was completely different.
40 seconds until Ame's back in the game, and Mineski know they're going straight for the tier 4s. They're looking to close things up here at TACFI again with the kick. 30 seconds, no anti-mage. They just can't slow this down, LGD. Mineski, the Southeast Asian legends, they absolutely are. Mushi ripped through LGD, the ancient wolf fool.
They have been playing Dota since 2013, but they never really won anything. They always come short against the best teams. They would lose to Liquid, Star Ladder, they would lose against Secret, Alliance back in the old days of OG, and it's a repetition. They really can never beat the big boys. However, in DAC, that is not the case.
Mineski, this team, you all know them, you all love them. IceIceIce, Jabs, Mushi, Ninja, Boogie, and Moon. What a journey they've been on here at LAN. I don't think anyone, or at least most people, expected this team to come out of the top, let alone take the championship title.
Yes, there are many Southeast Asian famous players, but they never really could gel together. This team encompasses 5 players, and these 5 players, they're not necessarily from Southeast Asia, but they just joined together to play for this squad. Currently, the roster has Ninjaboogie, Mushi, legendary mid laner IceIceIce, Jabs, and Nana. The only player from their team that's from the Philippines is Daryl. So, you can get the perspective here. But the point of the matter is that somehow these players got together and they made a heroic run. Going through the DAC, they literally rampaged through everyone. They were in the upper bracket and they could not lose. They just did not lose. They went against Team Secret, defeated them. VGJ Thunder, another great Chinese team, defeated them. Evil Geniuses, with their new roster, still defeated them. Then Optic Gaming, with Peter's new squad, defeated them, squashed them 2-0. Then VG Game came, gave a little trouble, no worries, 2-1 defeat. Then in the upper bracket, the semifinals, LGD Gaming, they whitewashed them 2-0. Then finally, LGD bounced back, come out of the lower bracket, defeating Virtus Pro somehow. But in the grand finals, LGD Gaming versus Mineski. You'd think LGD would learn by now. First losing in the semifinals, then losing in the PGL last year. But somehow, Mineski find a weakness. They exploited this team and they defeated them 3-2 in a best of 5 series to take the grand finals. They won about $370,000. This is by far their biggest achievement. Today, Mineski is sponsored by Gigabyte Steel Series and ESPN5. According to Mineski.net, the marketing manager of SteelSeries, Eugene Lee, said that they always wanted to work with Mineski. They said that Mineski is a Dota team that is not just a Dota team, but a whole organization that pushes esports, not only in the Philippines, but the entire Southeast Asia. Quote, the organization is very passionate about esports. And he says that, I know that the SteelSeries and Mineski shares the same passion. That's why we always wanted to work with them. So this just exemplifies what its sponsor feels about Mineski. Mineski is a team that you can invest in because honestly, they're just a very hardworking team. And folks, Daryl Kopi Chang, IceIceIce, is a prime example of Mineski. He actually symbolizes the entire team. You see, Daryl has been playing Dota for a long time, but he has always been suffering ridicule, similar to the way people look down upon fear from evil geniuses. But despite that, he still strives hard. He still continues to play and smiles with his famous smile. But with that being said, he is what Mineski is all about. He actually was the MVP of the entire DAC tournament. So similar to Daryl, if you're passionate about something, if you believe that you can accomplish something, go for it. Always push yourself and don't let others bring you down. Don't let the world bring you down. Follow your goals. This is what Mineski teaches us. This is what IceIceIce teaches you.
Plain Wilder, how did you invent it?
I didn't really invent it. Like, I was streaming one day on Twitch and then someone just said, hey, go play Winter Wyvern as a carry, it's not bad. And I played it one game, said, yeah, it's not bad. And I went to try it offlane, like, oh, it's not bad. And yeah, that's what happened. Some guy on Twitch just like, go try Wyvern, yeah.
So it was your idea, yeah?
No, it was their idea. It was a Twitch idea, like Twitch stream viewers idea. Okay.
This is the story of Mineski and how they became the Sea Kings. They conquered DAC. They have one of the most premier offlaner in history, perhaps, arguably, named IceIceIce. They have a great mid, Mushi, and they have other good supporting cast.
So these are some special stamps here for Mineski with each of their players' names on them.
With the win at DAC, they attained so many DPC points, it puts them almost directly invited to TI8. So brace yourself and keep on riding the waves as Mineski look to conquer the lands. Until next time, this is Crystalis Dota. Make sure you subscribe and join us because we love to give you the true stories, the in-depth analysis of Dota 2.